What is up, you guys? Welcome back to my channel. It's me, Shamika. I hope you're all doing amazing. So today I have to head into Michael's. I'm sitting in front of Michael's right now. I have to pick up some things for some Christmas props for our business, but I figured while I'm here I may as well do a little shop with me, because I know Michael's is gonna have a lot of awesome things for Christmas, and also great deals. So let's go in and see what they have available.
As soon as I walked in, I was immediately greeted by these beautiful glass ornament sets. As you can see, they come in tons of colors, and they were also two packs. So there was an 8-pack and there was also a 6-pack. But the best thing about it is that they were all 50% off. So they ranged around $8 to $10. These are so beautiful, so perfect for a fun tree. But my favorite were these iridescent clear bulbs that you can also use as a perfect DIY.
Up on the housetop, reindeer paws, out jumps good old Santa Claus, down through the chimney with lots of toys, all for the little one's Christmas joys. Ho, 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 who wouldn't go? Ho, 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 who wouldn't go? Up on the, up on the.
One of my favorite finds today would definitely have to be this pillow right here. Let heaven and nature sing, and it goes perfectly with this pearl and gold Christmas tree. Oh my goodness, it was just so beautiful. And Michael's by far has the best nutcrackers. They are so cute, and they come in two different colors. They're 20 bucks, but as you can see, a lot of their Christmas decor is currently 50% off. So that was the blue one. Now this is the gold one. I really like the blue. It's just more my style, but 10 bucks, and it was really solid as well. Like, it wasn't flimsy. So if you're looking for a little nutcracker to put on a shelf, then you know Michael's is the place to go. So they had an entire village set up of mini ornaments and mini trees, but then they had these sets of 7 pieces for $36.99, and then they were 50% off as well. That is such a great steal. And Michael's is literally the plug for garlands right now. They range from $20 to about $50. Again, most of them are 50% off, so they are such a great price. And also in terms of feet, it seems like most of them are around 6 feet or so. So perfect for a mantle or perfect for a bookcase. And I was just so impressed with the detailing. Now I will say, glitter galore. A lot of these garlands had tons of glitter, but a trick for keeping glitter under control is hairspray. You just take some hairspray to your garland or to whatever is letting the glitter fly all over your home, and that keeps the glitter under control. If you are going for a more fun feel and look to your Christmas decor this year, then there is an entire aisle dedicated just for you. Or even if you want to decorate a little girl's room or even a tween's room, there are some really cute pieces down this aisle for sure. This was just so fun and whimsical. I really loved the color, like the pops of colors in this aisle. not my style, but I do know that a lot of people love that colorful and fun and more lighthearted feel to their Christmas tree and decor over the Christmas season. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that. The pics, oh my word, they were so gorgeous and they were great prices because they range from about $8 to $2 and they were all 50% off. Perfect again if you're going for that, you know, lighthearted, just kind of whimsical, fun feel and look. These are perfect to stick in a tree or, you know, a fun little vase as a centerpiece, or just anywhere really. They're just so, so fun. My goodness, I literally picked the coldest day of the week to do this. Not a good idea, but I got all the props that I needed and now I'm going to head back home and just wrap up the day there because it is freezing and I also have to make lunch. So I'm making jackfruit tacos today. Like, who do I think I am? Shoving it up today. So I just got back home and Isaiah was left alone for not even 2 minutes. He just disappeared. We were together, he just disappeared. I came back. Look at this. He took all of the wipes out of the package. Every single one. Why did you do this? Why did you do this?
There is water.
Oh my goodness, Isaiah. What are you doing? Anyways, I literally cannot be bothered right now. I'm way too tired and I gotta go make lunch. It's 2 o'clock already. So I have less than an hour to make lunch. I'm making jackfruit tacos today. Are you ready for some tacos?
No.
No. Okay. Well, we're having tacos anyways, whether you want to or not. All right. So I've started this dish with some extra virgin olive oil, onion and garlic, and some green onion. This is how I like to start a lot of my meals because not only does it smell amazing, but it also gives the food a really, really good flavor. All right, so here's my jackfruit. And for those of you that don't know, jackfruit is a great alternative for meat. It really does act like me, and whoo, we're fogging up a bit here. Let me just step back. Okay, there we go. And it can take on literally any flavor because it is flavorless. So I'm just gonna cook this down in a little bit of, I'm gonna use some vegetable stock just to give this a little bit more flavor and add some seasoning that I'll show you in a bit. All right, so here she is. I've added my broth. I also added some orange juice for some acidity. Then I added some salt, black pepper, cumin, some, what else did I add to this? I also added coriander and paprika. So I'm just gonna let this cook down a little bit longer. Then I'm gonna shred it with a fork. Or if you have a potato smasher, that would work as well. Then I just preheated my oven. That's preheating right now. Stick it in the oven for a bit with my barbecue sauce and then go ahead and assemble. Okay, so I've cooked my jackfruit until most of the liquid was evaporated and then I just transferred it to a baking tray and I'm gonna stick this in the oven for a few minutes just until it's nice and crispy and charred. One thing to know about jackfruit though, when you put it in the oven, is that it does shrink in size, so it may not look like a lot when it comes out of the oven. So usually if you want to do a certain amount, then just double your recipe for the jackfruit, if that makes any sense, because once you stick it in the oven, girl, it acts like spinach. So just that one cooking tip about jackfruit. So I've added two different barbecue sauces to this that I'm just gonna smother the jackfruit in before I put it into the oven. So one of them is a homemade sauce made by my amazing husband, and then the other one is by this company called Creole Buccaneer. So that's there. Focus. This is not focusing. Okay, wait, let me see if I'll focus here. This is not focusing at all, but Oh my goodness. Oh, there we go. Okay, so Creole Buccaneer, that is their info. They make the most amazing southern barbecue food here in my city. So I just mix those two together. And I'm gonna smother it in this and then add it to the oven. And then before I serve it, I'm also gonna add some more of the barbecue sauce because you want this jackfruit to be completely covered in sauce. To accompany the tacos, I made a pear and apple and mango tomato slaw, as well as there's some chopped up kale. I just made this crema using gochugang, mayonnaise, and sour cream. It tastes so amazing. So this is what we're gonna top our jackfruit with, and I'm so excited to eat. So this is what the jackfruit looks like once it's all cooked up. I think I'm gonna turn off the oven now because they look nice and cooked all the way through. We got some nice char on some of them, so that's exactly what we want.
You guys, a little someone is home just in time to have dinner. Come sit down. What's up, Ethan?
Good.
Good? Did you have a good day today?
Yep.
I missed you.
Same.
You smell really good.
Oh, I told you I did, but I told you I had a bath.
You never told me that. I know you had a bath. I told you to have a bath this morning.
We go together.
Anyways, you guys, I am exhausted. The tacos are done. I'm gonna assemble them for everybody. And then I'm just going to relax because I did a lot of walking and a lot of standing today. But I hope you guys enjoyed this mini vlog / shop with me. If you like videos like this, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe. I'm trying to hit 500 subscribers by the end of this year. I think I can do it. I think we can do it, guys. I see new faces every single day. So thank you guys for always coming back, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Yeah,
you can come up and say bye.
Bye.
Bye. See you later. Say see you later.
See you later.
Oh, you're adorable. Are you adorable?
No, I'm adorable.
You're not adorable? I think you're adorable. Mwah.